Good evening. This is a basic BTC chart, which is there for Bitcoin, which is being traded. There is something which is happened here. Same thing happened somewhere here also. Now, when I was making these, I was waiting for you, I had just plotted these lines. Now, we'll see how it works, what actually is a railway track pattern and what it is. Somebody even asked me this question was, sir, ye kya stock market ke related hai? So I just said, yes, sir, it is regarding the patterns. Okay. So now let's start. Is my screen visible to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what are railway tracks? Railway tracks are two tracks on which our railway system runs, our mains run. It is world over the almost the same. What is this railway track pattern in trading? And what is its significance? This is basically a price action strategy, which helps you all to get into a trading on important levels. Everybody is comfortable in English, or somebody wants in Hindi also?
So English is enough.
Okay.
English, sir.
Okay. Now, what is a track pattern? Tracks are basically, this is a price action trading strategy. That is based on analyzing the lengths of two candlesticks of similar lengths, but of opposite color. I repeat, it's a price action trading strategy that is based on analyzing the lengths of two candles of almost similar lengths, but of opposite colors. We will, as we go on, we'll do it. The requirements is, one of the candle must be bullish, so that means it should be green, and other one should be bearish, and that should be red in color. When you see them together, it looks like a railway track. So once we start going forward, we will understand this. So there are two types of patterns we have. One is a bullish and one is a bearish pattern. There are a lot of candlestick combos which you all must know. People who are following the Facebook, I had posted how to trade on a hammer. Simple hammer is you wait for one more candle to form and just take the trade and keep the lower of the hammer as a stop loss. There are multiple patterns on support and resistances. You are supposed to take it. And these are simple patterns which one should know. So railway track is one of the patterns. It's not the ultimate, it's one of the patterns. So there can be two. One is bullish, that is where you look at the support. And what is bearish railway track pattern? What you look at the resistance. Now let's come down to the first thing. What is a bullish railway track pattern? It is the first candlestick is bearish. The first candlestick is bearish. This is bullish. The first candlestick has to be bearish. And the second candlestick is bullish. It forms at the support and there is a sudden change. So there is at a support level of your price action, whatever following you are following, whether you're using moving averages, Fibonacci, anything, this is what you look at. If anybody has heard of Oliver Wells, he has also described bull and bear power, and that is here only. So your first candle is bearish and second candle is bullish and it forms at a support. whatever you use as a support, it can be a moving average, it can be a fibonacci levels, it can be a trend line. Either way you want to do it. Now, what is a BRS? BRS is exactly opposite. You have a first candle is a bullish, that is a green candle, and then you have a red candle, and it is formed at the resistance. And this is also a sudden change. That means suddenly the momentum has changed towards opposite side. This is what happens here. No? I was trying to show you what happened here. So these are known as railway track patterns. Now, where are they more important? Where are these patterns? If it forms in between, it is not usually not important. Actually, they will form at a place of at least some importance, because that is the level where the buyer and the seller are going to come. It usually forms at support, trend lines, moving average, and Fibonacci levels. Or Fibonacci levels, whichever either of the four you will find them. We'll see them on the chart. It's not what I say, you should believe it. If it's I can show you, then it's fine. Otherwise, there's no point to me. Which time frame to be used is the next very important question everybody is going to ask. This is the most important question everybody asks. Every time frame has its own story. So if you are looking at 1 hour, then your targets are according to one. If you are looking at 1 minute, we are looking at 1 minute targets. Now let's say I was showing you 2 minutes, that is working. It does not really matter on which time frame you are trading. It is the pattern which is most important. It's not an absolute pattern, but there is something major which has happened in the change in the thinking, psychology of the market. Market mein us time kuch ajeeb sa hua hai. Us level pe. And if you are using price action techniques, then the pattern will work on every time frame. For me, it works on every time frame. Bahut baar main bolta hun webinar mein, यहाँ पे तो रेलवे ट्रैक फॉर्मेशन होंगे, ये तो यहाँ से गिरेगा शेयर. तो मैं वो इसको देख के मैं बोलता हूँ. सो दिस इज हाउ आई यूजुअली स्पीक ऑन दिस थिंग. आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू टेल यू सो दैट यू ऑलमोस्ट लुक एट इट विद डिफरेंट आइज. नाउ व्हाट इज बाइंग रूल? दिस इज योर सपोर्ट, दिस इज योर फर्स्ट रेड कैंडल. That is the bearish red candle you are having. This is followed by a green bullish candle. Moment it crosses the above of this candle, there is a close above it, you take an entry. This is your stop loss. And then you let the trade run. I will tell you how it's usually done. This is a different kind of a diagram which we have done. Usually the risk to reward ratio is 1:3. So if this is your stop loss, 3 times of that is your target. And that's simple. You can keep 2.5 also, and you can keep 2 also. 1:1 is too low target to it. You can do it. If somebody is very brave, he can trail a stop loss to ride the wave longer, because we don't know how long that wave is going to go. There's nobody who can predict it. If anybody who can predict it, he's God or he's an liar. I'm being very honest. So you can trail your stop losses accordingly. Same way is when you see a bearish. The upper of the two is going to be your stop loss. And the lower, moment the low is cut, you take the trade. Same risk to reward ratio. You can trail the stop losses to ride it longer. The only advantages which I personally feel so is, somebody was said me, sir, I waited for 1 year to understand how you take a 4 rupees stop loss and Ultratech cement. And I told them that I have been telling you each and everything in the webinar. You're not trying to listen it properly. This is the main reason why I have such a good risk reward ratio. So if I'm risking 4 rupees and I bought 200 shares, let's say, So my total risk is of 800 rupees, and if it moves 20 rupees, it becomes 1:5. And for 20 rupees movement in UltraTech is nothing. I book at 20 rupees and I'm out. One day I was so lucky that it went up to 100 rupees and my only stop loss was 4 rupees. It was 1:25. It is very fairly and very easily, it is spottable thing on the chart. Early entry, bigger profits, smaller stop loss. So you have more advantage of getting ending the trade into a profit. Or even if you lose, so you may lose or maybe 500, 600 or maybe 1,000 rupees a trade, which is pretty less. So for a trade, you are taking worth around about 8 lakhs or 10 lakhs. If your stop loss is not more than 800 rupees, I think so you have done justice to your money. Now, the biggest disadvantage is, at least in the Indian market, is you don't have all patterns which are equal. You will not have the candles which are almost of the same size. Very rarely you do get it, but you need to be a little more vigilant. So if your knowledge on price action is not very good, the chances of you making a profit are not very high. So you have to know basic price action, basic support and resistance you have to learn. I request everybody to keep their mics on. Trade only those which form at levels of significance. This is the first thing which everybody forgets. I'm very sorry, I first moved Mr. Oppo F15 because thrice he had unmuted himself. So trade only if it forms at level of significance. Maybe trend line, channels, Fibonacci levels, or maybe. The biggest problem is there is a one spike which comes and takes away your stop loss. This is the biggest drawback of placing a very small stop loss. I do face it many times. Even you are doing something like in Jubilant Food, there is a one wick will come and will take away your stop loss, and then it will fly to the other. Yesterday, I had posted a image of my earning in paper trade in gold in forex market. It was pretty high. And I use all these patterns at this at important levels. So we'll discuss, see all of them in one forex. So let's go and see some charts. Now see what's happening. Can you see my screen? Anybody please unmute.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
This is
not under my control. No? This is not under my control. I showed you deliberately the chart and I went out. Now how do I trade it? Because people say is, I will just move all the cards. They say that you take a trade moment you see a railway track. I say do it little more. You should be a little more cautious when you are doing it. Now, these are the places where the lines are touching. The price are stopping at multiple levels. Now, what happened here? You had a bullish followed by bearish. Now you see this bearish, it is a small candle. That's why this wave was a smaller wave. You don't take a trade when you moment it closes. No, wait for some time. Let a candle close below it. Let a candle close below it. That means this will not sustain. Now at what levels you should be very vigilant. When it's following, it will always stop at one level where the stock stopped while getting up. This is, it went up, it stopped here and then went up. So it will come and stop at the same level. That is your first target. If it breaks here, then you go for the second target up till. It will then come up till this point. Now you see, again, I will just show you this point. in this whole fall, this is the first place it stopped. And while getting up, it will stop here first. And the moment it crossed, it will then go and stop like this. This is how it goes up. So this is almost a ripe time for me to take a trade. It is closing here. I will take a short trade. This is my stop loss. And I will wait for almost this level to come. This is my first level to touch. It may come, it may not come. But my stop loss in a trade is very less. I personally believe that my stop losses should be very low. I should at least get it. So your stop loss somewhere, maybe you entered here, somewhere on about here, 4463. It is around about 100 rupees, 120 rupees stop loss. Let's see what happens. It may come here, but the target from here is very low. This is almost around about 120 only. So this is 1:1. But if I want to target up till here, then it is approximately 0.23. So three times of is 0.69. It will not touch this. It will not come up today. This 0.6. It should come maximum up till this one. This is 0.57. This is Robert. So that's why I say keeping 1:2 is a pretty good level of doing it. So my first level should be somewhere on board here. I should place it here. Anybody who can put up in his computer can update later on in the charts. I will show you on Indian stock market. So I only deal in these stocks like this. Now, see what happened here. See this point. What happened? This is a bearish railway track pattern. But did you have a candle closing below it? No. You had a green candle which closed within it. So this pattern is not valid. Now do one thing is, this was the lines we had put. Because we don't know what is going to happen in future. If I say I know it, just go and plot the higher of these two. What happened at that level? Again, a bearish, but the next candle was ready to blasted this candle away. So there was no sell in Bajaj Finance that day. And what happened was, this is your stop loss. This is your entry candle approximately. And you can see it very easily. It went up. It will come and retest only this level. And then it will start flying. Now I will just try to put it on any other time frame. Now anybody can make it. What is going to happen to Bajaj Finance on Monday? It should come down. It should come down.
Going down.
So we need another 15 minutes candle close below it. And this is our stop loss and we are taking the trade. I usually don't do it at a bigger time frame when I'm doing intraday. I'm being very honest. I do it on a very small time frame. You start decreasing the time frame, you will start seeing the magic here. Now if you are doing at 3 minutes, you had this candle coming. Now you are taking trade at 7451 and 7466 is your stop loss. 20 rupees was the same day you have made. Now you see here. You will not take a sell trade because there is no candle which is closing below the support line. So your lines drawing has to be perfect. If you don't know price action, so then please learn it from somebody. I'm just trying to just make the things easy for you. Now, what happened here was, bearish to this thing over. Agar aap isko ek time frame bade mein dekho, aapko nazar aa jayega ki ye isne kya banaya. Evening star, morning star. And wahi se market upar utar gaya. आप इसको और थोड़े बड़े टाइम फ्रेम में देखो तो आपको क्लियर कट नजर आ जाएगा कि इसने यहाँ पे पूरा पैटर्न बनाया था। आगे रेडवे ट्रैक आपका। तो सर ये तरीके होते हैं टू ट्रेड यूजिंग द कैंडलस्टिक पैटर्न। इट टर्न फ्रॉम द सेम प्लेस वेयर इट वाज एट रेजिस्टेंस, नाउ इट विल कम बैक एंड टच दिस लेवल फर्स्ट, दिस इज इट्स फर्स्ट 7409। फ्रॉम देयर इट विल मेक अ पैटर्न, व्हिच वे इट विल गो वी डोंट नो, बट वी विल ट्रेड ओनली ऑन अ पैटर्न। We are not going to trade on this. I don't trade on 45 minutes. I only see it if I don't have to take a wrong entry. Now I will show you my favorite ultra tech. This is my favorite stop. Ye dekho sir. Us din live session mein maine bola tha na ultra tech udne wala hai. Ye hai. See sir. Ek choti candle upar close 7416. 14 rupees ka stop loss and you let it run. You touch 50, that is 1:3 done target. आप ऐसी गलती करोगे, ये हो गया, इसके ऊपर गया। The candle has to close, इसके नीचे ये, ये भी तो support पे बना है आपका ना bullish. This is also bullish, but इसकी length और इसकी length देखो, इस green के ऊपर कोई closure नहीं हुआ. So we are not taking a trade. We will just sit down and relax. We'll wait the trade to come. Now at this level, you tell me, what is your stop loss? 10 or 12 rupees. Let's see it. So this is how I usually trade. So if anybody who has data, Dr. Kamal kaise trade karte hai? I trade like this. 14 rupees ka stop loss dala. Main itna bada to deta hi nahi stop loss. Pehli baat. I'm very honest. I will even decrease it to 2 minutes and see it. Aap dekho 2 minutes mein kitna pyara usne entry diya. 7406 pe meri entry honi thi. Yahi kahin pe maine entry le leni thi. ये मेरा 10 रुपए का स्टॉप लॉस और मैंने यहाँ पे ट्रेड करना था। मैं तो इस कैंडल पे भी ट्रेड कर लेता। आई ओनली वेट फॉर द कैंडल्स टू फॉर्म। इट हैज टू बी इन माय वे, अदरवाइज आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डू इट। अब देखो आपको किसी भी टाइम फ्रेम पे मिलेगा और उसी लेवल पे आपको सेल मिलेगी। ये आपको एक और रेलवे ट्रैक मिला, कहाँ रुका? इसी लेवल पे आके रुक रहा है आपका शेयर, इस जहाँ पे यहाँ पे पहले रुका था। सो इट विल स्टॉप एट द सेम लेवल वेयर यू आर ट्राइंग। So the shorter the time frame, the shorter the stop is going to be. So bigger the time frame you see it, the bigger is the move. Now let's try to see it on 1 hour. Yeah, dekhiye. Ye aapka railway track. 1 hour ki to resistance maine purani mark ki hui, itni upar hai. To bade time frame ka bada result. You can trail at every this thing is. Now you see that you had a railway track here also bearish. But this is at support. This is not at resistance. Iski value ye hai ki agar ye yahan hota. Agar wo yahan pe hai to nahi hota. Koi farak nahi padta. Ek wo IRCTC mein maine ek baar dikha raha tha. Ki wo cheekh cheekh ke bol raha tha. Maine to girna hai us din. Ye hai na jis din massive fall hua hai uska. 19th October ko. Let's bisect it. 19th October. So we'll go at 3 minutes. अक्टूबर को तो इसने बहुत अच्छे अच्छे पैटर्न्स बनाए। आप देखो रेलवे ट्रैक और आप लेट्स What happened here? सर बताओ अब आपको इस चीज में क्या डाउट है कि इतना मैसिव फॉल किसी स्टॉक में हुआ है एंड आपने 3 मिनट के टाइम फ्रेम में उसको कितनी बार पकड़ना है। ये देखो कितनी तगड़ी फॉल्स एंट्री करवाई है। यहाँ पे सारे लोग बुलिश में बैठ गए थे। ये देखो कहां पे फॉलो अप है इसका, वेयर इज द कैंडल विच इज क्लोजिंग अबाउट इट। ये तो आपने इफ यू आर गुड एट मेक ड्राइंग द लाइंस एंड फॉलोइंग द लाइंस, दिस इज द वे यू डू इट। अब आपका ये बना भी तो कहां जाके रुका? ये बुलिश आपका बना भी, इसके ऊपर कैंडल भी बांधी, नीचे थोड़ी आया। उसने अपना टारगेट पहले जरूर टच करना है, फिर वहां से वो गिरेगा। अब आपका इसी लेवल पे जस्ट एट दिस लेवल Did you? It stopped here only, na? This is the wick which is coming. It will stop at that level only. Once it will come and stop at that level. वहाँ पे एक आपको बड़ी wick मिलेगी. यहाँ पे आपको green candle मिली. अब आप इसको दो मिनट पे देखो इसी को. What happened? You had a small candle, and what we call this as ignored bar. This is known as ignored by Oliver Wells. 2 minutes time frame पे आपने trade करना है, and this is the small bar you are having. अब इसके ऊपर हम SMA 20 लगा देते हैं. Let's see it. What happens? मुझे नहीं पता. मैंने नहीं लगा के देखी. I don't need to put all this thing. Let's see whether the magic works or doesn't work. Below 20 SMA, you had an ignored bar. And it's down. Bullish on up. Sir, magic to aapko har jagah milega. Dekhne ke liye aapko dekhna aana chahiye. इसको सर प्रैक्टिस जब तक आईज आपकी देखने को इसको तैयार नहीं होगी यू विल नेवर बी एबल टू पिक अप. नाउ लेट्स पुट इट ऑन 1 मिनट. मैं तो बहुत छोटे टाइम फ्रेम में भी देखता हूँ. आप देखो इसको बड़ा अच्छा होगा. ये देखो बियरिश. ये है ना बॉडी मिलाते हैं इसकी हाई रेड की बॉडी और ये आपको वहीं पे ही सारा कुछ मिलेगा. यू विल गेट इट समवेयर अराउंड बट दैट लेवल. सो एनी क्वेश्चंस नाउ? आई एम ऑलमोस्ट डन नाउ.
सर व्हाट इज इग्नोर्ड बार? सर
हाय श्रीनिक, यू डोंट नो व्हाट इज इग्नोर्ड बार?
नो सर.
बाप रे बाप. See, ignored bar is a technique which has been described by Oliver Wells. Oliver Wells is one of the very good world's trader, and he described it in a very nice way. I think so. Any more question regarding this? Otherwise, then I will take on the other topic. I will stop the recording and take the. Anybody wants to ask any question?
Sir ji, Fibonacci levels आपने कहा था ना, तो swing high या swing low पे लेना है या फिर कैसा?
मैम एक समझ जाओ. Fibonacci retracement. ये high है ना मैम?
जी.
मैडम अब देख लो आपको मैंने आपके सामने ही प्लॉट किया.
वही 2 मिनट्स टाइम फ्रेम पे ही आपने स्विंग हाई और स्विंग लो का ट्राई किया. ये देखो
आपके ये 0.236 जी है ना आपका लेवल. हाँ ये आपका लेवल है. मुझे तो पता नहीं था ना मैडम. ये लेवल है ना यहीं से सपोर्ट लेते हैं ना 0.618 से कहते हैं मेजर सपोर्ट है.
हाँ जी.
यहाँ पे आपके ऊपर नहीं गया फॉलो अप नहीं आया तो नीचे आ गया आपका. इम्पोर्टेंट मैडम स्विंग लेवल्स नहीं है आपके लिए. कोई सपोर्ट रेजिस्टेंस नहीं है आपकी. सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज है यू हैव टू नो हाउ टू ड्रॉ सपोर्ट एंड रेजिस्टेंस.
ओके हाँ वो इम्पोर्टेंट है.
वो मैडम अगर आपको आता है किसी को आता है एक इंडिकेटर करा दूं और साथ में एक बड़ा मजेदार
हमारे लिए तो सही हो जाएगा.
एक क्षण हो गया मुझे ढूंढना पड़ता है. मैंने उसका नाम मैंने रखा हुआ है. मैं नहीं यूज कर. हाँ यार सपोर्ट एंड रजिस्टर्ड बाइक Calibrosi. I don't know. Please pardon my English. That point. Now this is a very kind of. You have to go and do some settings. Me change karna hota hai. Iska ye na labels hatane padte. Now this is a very very good indicator to have. Main isko kisi zamane mein bahut use karta tha. Ab nahi main karta. Isme kya hota hai ki aapki jo bhi support hai, wo resistance banti hai aur resistance support banti hai. Color change ho jata hai.
ओके
अब ये देखो रेड बुलिश. मैंने तो ड्रॉ नहीं किया ना मैम. उसने उसी लेवल पे आपकी एक वो शूटिंग स्टार लेके बना दिया आपको. ये बड़ा अच्छा एक इंडिकेटर. इसमें एक प्रॉब्लम क्या है इसमें ये जो है ना सेटिंग में जाके ना इनपुट्स में ये जो इनएक्यूरेसी लेवल है ना इसको पॉइंट टू कर सॉरी पॉइंट थ्री पे कर, हाँ इस पे कर पॉइंट फोर पे करके मैं छोड़ देता हूँ इसको. मैं इसको तब तक वेट करता हूँ जब तक ये मेरे रेजिस्टेंस पे जाके मुझे कोई इंडिकेशन ना दे. अब तो मैंने इसको यूज करना ही बंद कर दिया, बट आप इसको एक ध्यान से देखो आपके इस लेवल के पास क्या हो रहा है. अगर मैं इसकी इनएक्यूरेसी को और कम करता जाता हूँ, बढ़ाते जाता हूँ, सॉरी इट विल गिव यू एट ऑल द लेवल्स. आपको लाइंस बहुत फ्रीक्वेंटली दे रही है, बट ये फिर आपको फॉल्स एंट्रीज बहुत कराएगा. तो इसका जो डिफॉल्ट है दैट इज वेरी गुड वे ऑफ डूइंग इट.
0.4 की जरूरत नहीं है सर, 0.4
बस आप इसको ऐसे ही रहने दें. यू कैन यूज इट. अब देखो आपको इसी लेवल पे कुछ ना कुछ मिलेगा, उसने ड्रॉ कर देनी लाइन आपकी.
ओके
सो लेट मी सी इट, लेट मी ट्राई टू शो यू ऑन. मान के फायदा तभी होता है कि इफ आई एम एबल टू शो यू चीज का, नहीं तो फायदा कुछ नहीं होता. लेट्स गो एंड सी इट ऑन क्रिप्टो. मेरा तो फेवरेट बीटीसी है. अब आप देखो बीटीसी को कहां से पढ़ रहे हैं. आपका बीटीसी का पहला लेवल टच हो गया?
हाँ जी
हो गया. फर्स्ट टारगेट डन. मैंने तो आपके सामने ही लगाया, मैं तो देखा भी नहीं था, मैं तो भूल गया था. द फर्स्ट टारगेट इज डन इन बीटीसी. No, one can, if somebody is an aggressive player, मैं जैसे बड़ा aggressive हूँ, मैं तो इसका stop loss यहाँ ले आऊँगा कि जाए तो 100 रुपए ही जाए, अगर नहीं जाता तो चलने. And I am able to write big moves. आपका यहाँ पे भी देखो क्या बना दोबारा उसी level पे जाके. Let me remove this. What is there? What has formed here? आप इसको 1 मिनट पे देखें. वहीं पे आपको गेम वहीं पे मिलेगी. अब ये लाइन ड्रॉ की थी, वहां पे क्या मिल रहा है आपको? बुलिश. सो आई डोंट यूज टू मेनी इंडिकेटर्स, बट दिस इज वन आई लाइक वेरी मच. ये आपको देखो छोटे छोटे ट्रेड्स बड़े अच्छे देगा. यहाँ पे चलो 1 मिनट इज टू नॉइजी, बट आप इसको देखो यहाँ पे आपको दे रहा है जब फॉलो अप देता. अच्छा, इट गिव्स यू अ गुड रीजनेबल थिंग. आपको एक ट्रेड अच्छे बीच में से निकाल के दे देगा. डोजी में आया था ट्रेड. डोजी वाज ए ट्रेड व्हिच आई हैड टुडे आफ्टरनून. आपको लाइन ड्रॉ मिल रही है, आपने दिमाग नहीं लगाया, आपने कहा ये मेरा स्टॉप लॉस हो गया, मैं छोड़ दूं. द प्रॉब्लम इज ऑफ दिस इनएक्यूरेसी. दिस इनएक्यूरेसी जस्ट हिट्स यू बैडली, सो यू कैन जस्ट मैन्युअली ट्राई टू डू इट. आपका रुका कहां जाके? नाउ लेट मी स्टॉप इट. नाउ आई एम नॉट, आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू डू इट फॉर यू ऑल. मैं तो 3 कैंडल पीछे से मार्क करता हूँ हमेशा. मुझे नहीं पता कहाँ जाएगा स्टॉक, कहाँ पे कुछ हो गया. मैं तो इसको देख के मार्क कर रहा हूँ, मुझे नहीं पता नीचे और कहाँ जाएगा. आप अगर पहले को देख के करोगे तो आप बचे रहोगे. अब आप इसको जरा ध्यान से देखो व्हाट्स हैपनिंग. आपका यहाँ भी क्या बन रहा है? इसको आप थोड़ा सा टाइम फ्रेम बढ़ा रखो तो आपको नॉइज थोड़ी सी कम होगी. तो कहाँ जाके रुक रहे हैं? इसी लेवल पे रुक रहा है हमेशा स्टॉक. चल अब यहीं तक आएगा, पूरा यहाँ आएगा. सो वेंस यू स्टार्ट ऑब्जर्विंग द चार्ट्स ना, तो आप लोगों को बहुत नॉलेज आ जाती है. आप लोगों में से किसी ने विक्स के बारे में पढ़ा? व्हाट इज अ विक? ये डंडी को विक कहते हैं. हाउ यू ट्रेड यूजिंग ए विक? एनीबडी हैज एन आइडिया?
नो सर.
नहीं सर, कभी ट्रेड नहीं लिया जाता विक देख के.
अरे पापे, विक की ट्रेडिंग नहीं सीखी कभी? चलो मैं आपको एक छोटा सा हिंट दे देता हूँ. इसका किसी दिन डिटेल वेबिनार लूंगा मैं. ये भी एक बड़ी मजेदार वे है. अब देखो इतनी सारी ऊपर की तरफ, लेट मी स्टॉप द रिकॉर्डिंग बिकॉज नाउ आई एम गोइंग ऑफ.